From the point of view of observations of the Earth's surface, these changes of this internal field are a few tens of nanotesla per year. On the other hand, the field is modulated by solar activity, and these changes can be even up to 1,000 nanoteslas per hour. And the role of Germanic Observatory is to monitor both, to monitor these quick changes and as well as these long-term development. It means that our method must be very precise and stable for decades or hundreds of years if possible. Well, the Germanic community is well organized itself. However, there is difficult to link to our data set to data sets from other communities, and EPOS will address just this issue. We'll present Germanic data in a modern way. And we have another group is magnetotellurics. Well, magnetotellurics means this magnetotellurics monitors this short-term variations of geomagnetic field and geoelectric field, and having this data we can make some estimations of the conductivity below our feet in the Earth. Magnetotelluric data were not integrated up to now. They are stored only by the providers, and so it's challenge of this EPOS to organize simply access to magnetotelluric data and make them available to the whole geoscience community. Yeah, we offer in the first stage geomagnetic observatory data. Observatory data means that they are those data that can monitor this long-term development as well as this short-term variation of geomagnetic field. And another types are variometer data. These variometer stations don't take care of these long-term variations. They just study this short-term variation, which is called geomagnetic activity. We also collect geomagnetic activity indices and events. There are some characteristics, let's say for example KP index, there are 8 numbers per day that can characterize the level of disturbances of geomagnetic field. If it is quiet field, of its magnetic storm. Of course, there are also global magnetic models like International Geomagnetic Reference Field or World Magnetic Models, which combine this data with satellite data to get global magnetic field. My challenge regarding just this global magnetic models, because recent satellite magnetic missions provided huge amount of high quality data, and combine this data with observatory data and this repeat station data, we can get much better global and regional models of the geomagnetic field, that is models with higher resolution. As regards these magnetotelluric studies, and if they are proper analyzed, it can improve our knowledge about the structure of the Earth's crust and lithosphere. We have interaction actually nearly with all other packages, with seismology and with geological data. We can together improve models of the Earth's lithosphere, Earth's mantle and Earth's core. Less simple is to give in access to the metadata that is so important for future research to understand how the data were recorded. One of the goals of geomagnetic work package in EPOS is to build an international metadata system that will be also able to store this information, so that the work we do today can be understood also tomorrow. And integration of the geomagnetic and magnetotelluric data and product services software into integrated core services will simplify access to these data and services, and thus increase the download and usage of the data across not only geosciences community. It itself is really a large challenge. Well, it won't be easy to construct it, to get together so different communities and so many institutions participate in on it, but if it succeed, and I believe it will succeed, of course, so it will be quite new quality in geoscientific data.